Hi there and welcome back to the Floss Marketing School. In this video I will explain you how you can install Octoprint on GNU Linux Ubuntu, and for this I would like to thanks first of all Lucas Winkler, who is really the one behind, let's say, the full project, explaining me everything that we need to know in order to do it step by step. I'm not going to show, in fact, how to install it in real time, but I'm just going to explain you all the different steps I went through in order to install it. I installed it for the GTEC 3D printers, and which is the Prusa i3 Pro and Pro B. And yeah, what I found is kind of disappointing is that when you follow the user manual of these given 3D printers, they are telling you to use RepeaterHost, and RepeaterHost is a software which is not open source. It used to be open source, but it's not open source anymore. So I contacted Lucas, asking him if he can help me install Octoprint. And I found many tutorials on the web about Octoprint, but they were all about Raspberry Pi. So I had no idea how to install it for GNU Linux. And he explained me the full process. Octoprint is a 3D printer software which is open source. And once installed, it's installing a local server. You can even install it on a real server in order to have your printer connected and accessible through anywhere. And it works very well with the GTEC Prusa that I just showed you. Okay, so now let's go through the different steps that you need to go through. So the first thing are the requirements. So in order to install Octoprint, what you need to have is to have a Python 2. So it's released as well for Python 3, it's just that it's not as stable, and of course you don't want the application to crash when you are using it. So first thing that you need to perform is Python 2 version on your terminal in order to check what is the version of Python that you are using. And then you need as well to install Python virtual environment, because you don't want to mix all your different Python version. Okay. Once you have done those two things, what you need to do is that you need to create a folder, so mkdir octoprint, and then you get within this folder. So you do a cd octoprint. When you are within the octoprint folder, what you do is that you run virtual environment and then Python and Python 2 octoprint, and then once you are doing so, then you enter within the following folder. So when you run this, it's going to download many things, and it's going to install, let's say, Octoprints, and then you need to enter within the folder. So you do a cd octoprint slash bin, and then you can execute the following command, which will install actually Octoprint. So this command is just downloading the stuff, and this one is installing the stuff. So once everything has been downloaded and installed, then you need to stay within this same directory, and within this same directory you will get another program installed, which is Octoprint. So just run dot slash octoprint and it's gonna run it. It may happen that the port which is used by default by Octoprint, which is the 5000, is already busy by another app. I mean, that was the case for me. So if that's the case, okay, you will see an error message when you try to run this given command. And in order to change the port which is used by default by Octoprint, which is 5000, then you need to just do cd tilt, and then put on your home of your computer. Then you go for nano dot octoprint slash config yaml, and then you will enter within the config yaml file when you need to add ports, and then you explain which one you would like to use, and then just use exactly the same indent. So you just add like two space, and then you copy and paste port 2 point space, and then the port number that you would like to use. Once it's done, you just save the file, and then you can access to your Octoprint server by just typing localhost 2.1234 if that's the new port that you are using, or either the 5000 if that's the one that you wanted to use. Once you are doing so, you will access to a page like this on which I will ask you to configure Octoprints. There's not much to know here. So for example, you need to specify the access control, so the credential that you want to use. Then you really need to explain if you allow to send anonymous data to the Octoprint team. Then you need to check as well to check or uncheck the online connectivity check, then to enable or disable the plugin blacklist, and so on and so forth. So you go through all those different steps, which do not require any, let's say, any advanced configuration. Probably the only thing that you need to take care of is they will ask you when you need to configure the 3D printers. They will ask you for the hot end and the extruder, including the nozzle diameter. Then if that's the case, look through your manual of your 3D printer in order to know which is the value which is expected. So for example, here they're telling me that the diameter of the nozzle of the extruder should be 0.4 millimeters. So that's the only thing that you need to do. Then regarding your server running, if you would like to start to print or to even have your printer connected to Octoprint, just to let you know that you will need as well to say that your identifier, so to say the name that you are using in order to connect to your computer, has the rights to do so, and that it belongs to the group of Octoprint. So in order to do so, you need to run sudo user mod and this given line with here your identifier, which is the one that you are using in order to log in on your computer, and same thing over here, in order to complete the instruction. And then once you are doing so, you will get the UI of Octoprint on which you can start to play with. I'm already starting to use it since this afternoon. I have to say that to me, it's far better than RepeatTier. It's far more intuitive. You can easily control the different tools that you have, including the bed, including the extruder in itself, and you can easily import the different configuration that you have, the different profile, in order to speed up the process. And that's it for everything that I wanted to show you today. Thanks for watching.